He had done also something else. He'd tried to develop techniques so that he could look at cells with the electron microscope. So in addition to the centrifugation techniques, he developed techniques for thin slicing, for embedding thin slicing of material to look at with an electron microscope, which at that time, of course, was already in use, not at the Institute, but by some company in New York, not at all for biological purposes, but for looking at metals. And in this work, Claude had become helped by a man called Keith Porter, who became one of the most famous electron microscopists in the United States, and also by a younger man from Romania called George Palade. And so I went to visit Claude. He was another one of my heroes, of course, at that time. And he was very kind, told me about his work, and showed me at some moment, he said, there's a young man here that I would like you to meet. And this young man was George Palade. And later in the story, of course, I will mention how Claude Palade and I ended up sharing the 1974 Nobel Prize in medicine. But of course, at that time, I didn't know that this was going to happen. Anyway, I knew about Claude's technique. And so coming back to my experience with glucose-6-phosphatase, I decided from the work of Albert Claude that this agglutination of the particles containing the enzyme meant, of course, that it was bound to some kind of particle. And so I decided, well, would it be worth our while to apply the Claude technique to find out where this enzyme is situated? And it was touch and go, because this was quite an investment of time and effort to develop the technique in the lab. And was it worth the investment just to know something about where this enzyme is? And so I decided, well, if this enzyme interferes with the action of insulin, maybe it would be important to know where actually it is in the cell. So let's do it. And fortunately, I had an extremely able co-worker, Jacques Berthet, who's helped me in much of the work. And he was largely involved in reading the literature on this topic and developing the techniques in the lab so that eventually we could use them. And also, Claude had returned to Belgium by that time so that I could ask him for advice. I was never a student or a pupil of Claude, but we did get advice from him.